This is really a great moment for the class of 2019. Our Engineering for Humanity vision is on display in so many of these projects here today.
Bike riding in New York City, it's not very accessible to handicapped people, to people that are pretty uneasy riding bikes. What we are developing here is a completely modular device that attaches onto a city bike without any modifications to the bike at all.
We built an upper limb assistive technology for children with cerebral palsy that monitors their movements of their upper limb.
You're gonna see a flashing screen, which is basically a biofeedback mechanism that lets the kid know you haven't used your arm in a while. You might wanna start using it.
What we worked on is a drone airplane hybrid. It can take off like a drone and land like a drone, but fly in the air like a plane.
This is a method for the early detection of mastitis, which is infections that occur in breastfeeding mothers. So we're using IR thermosensing to basically detect temperature and alert women that there might be infection.
Something I've really learned at Columbia is that we're engineering for humanity. And in order to do that, we need to be in touch with humanity to understand their needs firsthand.
So our building is LEED Gold certified. We have several green roofs on the building, and our building has a really big water filtration and recycling system.
This is our Save the Trout team. So we were working to develop a framework to govern this bank of water that has been set aside to protect the trout population. I think because we're here in New York City, we have access to really cool problems.
It's a modular solution for battery storages and also charging technologies. And you can use this as a scaled solution to power your house, or you can use this as a very nicely packaged solution, so you can basically just carry the grid along with you.
I'm shifting gears now.
This is a non-slip, continuously variable transmission for a bicycle. There's no intermittent shifting loss, and there's an infinite number of gear ratios.
You had to analyze the original classic Buchla, figure out what's wrong with it, correct it, yeah. And then you made that to look exactly like the original Buchla. This is a commercially viable product, as is. The expo gives the seniors an opportunity to use what they've learned to make something fun for themselves, but all of it represents intense effort and a lot of creativity.
This is an automated pet care machine, the Pet Minder. It is capable of feeding multiple pets in a household and limiting the amount that they eat or drink as well.
This is our senior design project, the Prespice, an automated spice dispenser.
So it brings the first spice forward, and now it's going to do about 8 revolutions, and all of our spice will be there.
The things that we were able to learn within 4 years really allowed us to actually put our skills to use and build something that's functional and actually usable in the real world.
It's a celebration of their evolution from being students to being engineers.
Congratulations, everybody.